subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I'm Raghuveer. In this class, we'll discuss about our next data preprocessing technique called one-hot encoding. In our previous classes, we already discussed about some of the data preprocessing techniques. What those techniques are, min-max scaling, normalizing and standardizing. These are on numerical data. But one-hot encoding is a technique on categorical data. The discussion about what's numerical data, what's categorical data, and what's text data, we already made this discussion in our previous classes. So please watch those videos from the beginning and come back here. So this is the data set which we considered from the beginning of the data preprocessing, housing price prediction data set. In this, we are having housing size is given in square feet and the location of the house and the cost of the house in lakhs. Size of the house is 1200 square feet and the location is in Bombay and the cost is 12 lakhs. This is the numerical data and this is categorical data. Why it is categorical data? It's divided into, we took this data on three different locations. What are those locations? Bombay, Delhi and Chennai. We are having three different categories. That's why we call it as categorical data. So now we understand what's the problems we come across with categorical data and then we go for one-hot encoding. So what's the problems we come across with categorical data? The categorical data, in most of our ML models, we do some basic calculation, basic algebra in the model. What's that is comparing two different features. What's the features means columns, identifying the distance between two different data points. Like that, we do some basic algebra on the data. This we already discussed in our first model. What's the first model? Linear regression model. We have done so much of math in linear regression model. So in order to do that calculation, this categorical data is given in which format? String format. We cannot do calculation on this categorical data. That's why we have to convert this categorical data into numerical format. So one of the way to convert this categorical data into numerical format is just assigning the numbers. Bombay 1, Delhi 2, Chennai 3, like that. Bombay 1, Delhi 2. We can simply assign numbers, but this is not the right way. Why it is not the right way? When coming to algebra means calculations, this 1, 2, 3, we are given more weightage to Chennai. We are given more weightage to Delhi when compared to Bombay. We have given more weightage to Chennai when compared to Delhi. So that is the reason we should not use this method. When we are using in calculations like identifying the distance between two different points, this has given more weightage, but our intention is not to give more weightage. What's our intention? Just to separate the categories. So that's the reason we should not use this simple method assigning the numbers. So what we use is, we will go for one-hot encoding. What's this one-hot encoding do is, how many different categories we are having here? Three different categories are there. What are those? Bombay, Delhi and Chennai. Take these features and take it into single feature each. Feature means take it into single column each. So what we do is take the first line. What is showing? Bombay. At Bombay, place one, remaining all zeros. At Delhi, second one, take the second one. At Delhi, place one, remaining all zeros. Like the same way, next Chennai, 001, Bombay, 100, 010. This is what one-hot encoding is. Okay, coming to the coding part, how to do this one-hot encoding? Coming to the coding part, let's take the code here. Import pandas as PD. My is equal to, this is a dictionary which we create, a dictionary housing size 1200. This is the data which we are collecting, we're placing it in a dictionary. Location is equal to Bombay, Delhi, Chennai, Bombay, Delhi. and we are taking this dictionary into a data frame. The discussion about dictionaries, data frame, what data frame will do. Data frame will convert our data into tabular format. This is all already discussed in our first classes of the coding. Hope you already watched those videos. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. Okay, we are taking our data. We are taking our data in a tabular format. This is what we collected there. So now we have to take this categorical column and convert into one-hot encoding. For that reason, we are taking from sklearn.featureextraction.text import count vectorizer. This is the class which we use to convert our categorical data into one-hot encoding. There is a separate class on one-hot encoder to do one-hot encoding, but we are using this. Why we are using this is, in our next classes we'll use the same method to convert our text data. You can use this class also, but you please try using this one-hot encoding. How to check this one-hot encoding? What's the methods we have in one-hot encoding? How this can be helpful with an example is given in the documentation. We already discussed how to check the documentation in our initial classes, how to code ML. So please watch that and identify. You do it as an assignment, how to do one-hot encoding using the class one-hot encoder. We follow this method, count vectorizer. You take it as an assignment. Okay, this count vectorizer is assigned to a variable. This class is assigned to a variable called v dot fit of my_df. my_df means we converted our data dictionary into data frame and we assigned it to a variable called my_df. In that we are picking the location, so location values. So what's this fit method do? The fit method do is, how many different categories are there, what's these names, this identified in fit method, so that we are getting ready for transformation. When this categorical data is converted into this format, in the transform method it will convert this data into this format. So v dot transform of my_df location dot values, you transform those values into this format. We placed this in a variable called x. If you display x value, it will display in a sparse matrix format. What's the sparse matrix is? See here, in this matrix format, we are having most of the values are zeros. Only few values are having a value called 1. This type of matrix we call it as sparse matrix. If most of the values are zeros, then we call it as a sparse matrix. In order to save memory space, we'll show this sparse matrix in this format. This is the basics of data structures. We discuss these concepts in data structures about sparse matrix and how it will show the sparse matrix in this format. How it will show is, 0th line, 0th column is having a value called 1. First line, first column is having a value called 1. Second line, second column is having a value called 1. Third line, 0th column is having a value called 1. Fourth line, first column is having a value called 1. This is how it will show the data in sparse matrix. But in order to convert this sparse matrix into a matrix array format, we are using this method called x.toArrayOf is a method. So that we will convert this into this format. For better understanding, we converted this to array format. With experience, no need to convert this into array format. Coming to this v.get_feature_namesof, what's this method do is, whenever you apply the fit method will identify what are the different categories that we have in this location, Bombay, Delhi and Chennai. These are converted into features. It will display the list of features which it collected during the fit method. It will display, what's this method display is, Bombay, Delhi and Chennai. If you are having 50 different categories, it will display the 50 different features names. Okay, this is all about one hot encoding. Now let's execute this code in our system.
Coming to coding part, this is our program which written in the board. Okay, import pandas as pd, my is equal to, we are creating a dictionary here, housing size is equal to 1200 1300, this is the housing size values, house size values, and location Bombay, Delhi, Chennai, Bombay and Delhi. We are using this dictionary into the data frame, so that we are converting this data into a tabular format. We are assigning a variable called my_df to the data frame. So from sklearn.feature_extraction.txt, import count vectorizer. Vectorizer is equal to count vectorizer of. We are assigning this count vectorizer to a variable called vectorizer. Okay, then we are fit on data my_df of location. Location means it will consider only the location column. What's it having? It will take the values. What fit method do? We already discussed it previously. After that, we are applying transformation on the location data. So here I will show you how it will display the sparse matrix in which format. Let's execute this. So we execute this. Okay, this is the sparse matrix format. 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 1. So like that, it's displayed in the sparse matrix. In order to display it in the list within the list, that is two-dimensional, multi-dimensional array format, we are converting this to two array of x dot. See here, we used the vectorizer dot get feature names of, what's the feature names it's displayed? Bombay, Chennai, Delhi. Okay, this is how we code for one hot encoding. You please try it using the method called one hot encoder, using the class called one hot encoder. Okay, hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.